Good afternoon, class. My name is Bayo Oguyeme, like I already know, and this is music one for rudiment of music. Rudiment of, and today the topic we'll be taking is interval. What is an interval? Interval is actually the distance between one musical note to the other. You know, when we were talking about scales, we're talking about tone, semitone. That means the distance between G, for instance, the treble clef, to A, to B, to C. The distance between Do and Re. The distance between Of or Up. So that's what we'll be looking at today. And I brought a specimen of a keyboard. That means the distance is a keyboard. The distance between C, like you already know that C, and C sharp, you know, it's a semitone. The distance between C and E. The distance between C and the C upper octave. Those are the things we'll be going through today. And first, there are ways to describe intervals. Intervals are described either in major, minor, perfect, augmented, and diminished. They are what you call perfect unison. That means when the note is not moving. When the note is not moving. If I strike C, if I strike middle C twice, it's not moving. It remains C. That means if I ask you to describe the interval, that's a perfect unison. And another type of interval is major second. Major second is when I move a whole tone. When I move from D, when I move from C to D, for instance, that's a tone. You know, in scales, there are like movement of a tone. Movement from Do to Re. Movement from La to T. Those are a whole tone movement. That's what is described as major interval. Another type of interval is what we call minor second. Minor second is when I move from distance of a semitone. If I move from F to F sharp, I have moved a semitone. I have not actually moved the whole tone. That means that's what we call a minor second. A minor second. Another type is called a major top. Major top interval is when I move a whole two tones. One, two, three. When I move from C to D, I've moved a whole tone. When I move from D to E, I've moved two. You know, that's what we call a major top interval. Then there's minor top. Minor second. We also have a minor tone. A minor tone is when you move a whole tone and a semitone. That means you have not completely moved two whole semitones. When I move from La to Do, when I move La to Do, La to D is a whole tone. T to Do is a half tone. That means that to describe that type of interval, you say it's a minor tone. There we go. Perfect fourth. Please note, there's no minor fourth or major fourth, there's perfect fourth. If movement of a fourth is described as perfect, for instance, if I move from C, from mid to C, which I've been citing as an example for you, from mid to C to F, that's a fourth. And how do you describe that? A perfect fourth. It consists of two whole notes and an half tone. Two whole notes and a half tone. That means it's a half tone higher in pitch than a major third. Then there's perfect fourth, a perfect fifth. Perfect fifth is when I move from C, for instance, I've always been using C, or let me use F now. When I move from F to C, that means I move from Do to Re to Mi to Fa and to So. How do you describe that? That is described as a perfect fit. I have moved from F or G. If I move from G, for instance, to D, I have moved perfect fit. Because I have moved two old notes, one up to, and another old note altogether. It consists of four or three old notes and half tone. Then we have major sixth. Major sixth, like you know, there are seven notes on the scale, do, re, mi, la, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Those are the seven. But when I move from C, middle C, to La, C, D, E, L, G, A. When I move from C to A, I move the sixth. And if it consists of four old tones and an half tone, that's a major sixth. Same thing is, then we have minor sixth. Minor sixth is less half tone. It's major sixth, less half a tone, just like minor tone, which I described before, which is major tone, less half tone. Then there is major seventh. Major seventh. That means you have moved a seventh. That means you move from do, for instance, to T. That's a major seventh. And there is what we call minor seventh. Then all others can be augmented or diminished. What I mean by that, apart from having a major, minor, perfect interval, then we have what we call augmented and diminished. When a minor tone is further reduced down by a semitone, how do you describe that? It's actually a minor tone. But you now further reduce it by a semitone, it becomes a diminished interval. When a major tone, for instance, is increased by a semitone, how do you describe that? It is augmented, it is propped up by a semitone. Then we have some which we will not, but let me mention it for sake of mentioning. We have double diminished. When a diminished interval is further diminished down, it becomes double diminished. When an augmented interval is further augmented by a semitone, it becomes double augmented. Then we have perfect octave. How do you describe? We describe perfect octave. There are two types of interval, namely harmonic interval, melodic interval. When you play the two notes together, when you strike the two notes together, like same time, that is harmonic interval. You can see it. The D and the A here is struck together. The D and the F here is struck together. That is harmonic interval. Then you have melodic interval. When it is played, scattered, melody. When it is not, when it is spaced, for instance, the E to G here, if you play it on a keyboard, you're going to separate it. That's a melody interval. And let's take the scale of C. Let's use the scale of C as our example here. Let's look at the various intervals. Look at the first note here. C, double note, double meaning on the C. If I play it on the piano, I'm not going to move my hands. That means I'm being on unison. That's what we call perfect unison. Perfect unison. I strike it once and it's unison. The second note, a D and a C and D play together. A C, middle C and D play together. The interval in that case, it's a major seventh. It is a major seventh. Then the third one, a C and a D flat. A C and a D flat. Look at our model there. A C and a D flat. It has not completely moved a tone. It has only moved a semitone. It has only moved from C to D flat. If you have moved to D, it will become an old tone. In that case, what do we call that? That's a minor interval. Because it's just like moving from La, no, from T to Do. It's just like moving from me to far. That's a minor interval. Look at the third one here. A C to E. A C on the keyboard to E. Just ta, ta, ta. It has moved completely to semitone. That's a major third. And the third one, a C to E flat. I said when a major third is further reduced, and like you know already, a flat sign reduces a tone by half tone. Okay? In this case, it has reduced the E by a half tone. It has reduced the two whole tones, which I could describe as major tone, by a half tone. What do we describe that? We say it is a minor tone. Look at this one, a C to F. Distance from C to F. In turning so far, we call it Do to Fa. It's a fourth. Do, Re, Mi, Fa. That's a fourth. And that's a perfect fourth. Please know there's something like minor fourth or major fourth. It is a perfect fourth. And when you further reduce the F up by a half tone, by a semitone, you have reduced Do to Fa by a half tone. That one becomes a diminished fourth, not a minor fourth. A diminished fourth. And the fifth one, same thing. A C to G is a fifth. That's a perfect fifth. A perfect fifth. And when you reduce a perfect fifth by a semitone, you get what we call a diminished fifth. But like you know like I always say, you can also reduce the bass. It is not only the upper note that could be reduced. How do you reduce the bass of the note? By putting a sharp sign. For instance, the C to F is a fifth, it's a fourth. If I raise the C below by half two, I've reduced the interval because I've knocked up a semitone. It becomes a diminished interval. Likewise, this is major six, C to A, C, D, E, F, G, A. That's a sixth. If you reduce, now look at it. C to A is a sixth. C to A double flat. Because C to A is a sixth. C to A flat is a minor sixth. C to A double flat becomes, I have removed semitones twice. It becomes a diminished sixth. A diminished sixth. A diminished sixth. Then the next one is C to B is your C to B, and that means your C to your leading note. That means your Do to your T. The distance C B E F G A B. That is a seventh. For if you push the B by a semitone and harmonically, which will have the C, you have increased that major seventh. By half two, it becomes an augmented seventh. Augmented seventh. Then the same thing is applicable to D, to scale of D. Now, how to determine interval? If you are looking, if you see an interval, how? What are the criteria? What are those things that you look at to properly describe an interval? The first one. Use the bass note at your tone, like I used it there. What we described there, we are using the C, regardless of the key signature. We are using the C, which is the bass, which is the tonic, and which is the bass as our tonic. It is from that C that we begin to calculate. And look at this D, for instance. This is D. We are using the D as our tonic. So whatever we're going to calculate, the D becomes significant. For instance, look at this D to F sharp. Normally on the scale of D major, F sharp is generic to C major. F sharp is part of C major because that is the top. If you have to describe it, since F sharp is the top, is the generic member of that thing, it is a top. So it is important you use your bass as your tonic, regardless of whether it is harmony or melody. When you are to describe an interval, look at your bass note and take it as a theory and begin to calculate. And look at the, determine the generic notes of that back bass room, if it is E flat or list. You know the key signature of E flat is B and A. So when you see an interval, when you are asked to describe an interval starting from a B flat, you take the B and B flat as your tonic, then you calculate. If, for instance, if you are getting to F, you know B flat to F, that's a fourth. But if you are now seeing F sharp is not generic to E flat. You begin with it, then you know that it has been pushed by an F to becomes augmented. Another factor determines, I said, take cognizance of the key signature. Now, when you have looked at the bass note, it is important before you put down your pen on paper to look at the key signature, because in some instances the key signature plays significant role. Yeah, let's take this for instance. There's a key signature here which indicates that this here is a B flat. So if you take this as B flat as your bass, and your axe will determine the interval of an E. You know, B to E, 1, 2, 3, 4, it's a 4. And the E is not, for now, it's not carrying any accidental, but the B flat is effective here. That makes it perfect fourth. That makes it perfect fourth. If you look at this, B, F to D, F becomes your base. This is your tonic. And you begin to calculate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's a 6. Then you need to take cognizance of the accidentals. If peradventure there are accidentals in the note being given. For instance, let's look at this. This is D to A sharp. D, like I said before, D becomes your tonic. D becomes your B. Then you calculate. But then note, in calculating interval, the note, the actual note, it's your first. You don't start calculating from the next note. The D becomes your one. The D becomes your one. It becomes your third. So you have to count the D, because people make so many mistakes. You begin to count from the next note. No. Because the note, in music, that particular note, it's important. So you count from D, one, E, two, 3, 4, 5, that's a 6. But like I said, there's an accidental on the 6th note. And what's the nature of the accidental? It's a sharp. A sharp pushes forward. Then when it pushes forward, it increases by a semitone. That means it cannot be described as a major 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. That's a 5th. It cannot be described as a pattern. It is augmented because it has been pushed forward by the center. Lastly, I want you to look at these exercises and we quickly look at it. Be careful, like I said, use the bass notes as a tonic. Be careful of the accidentals. Determine whether the key, the notes are falling in the generic notes of the scales. This exercise before we go and we'll continue less. Thank you.